Mark hoped to bury his sadness in a whole thing of candy beans, but it just wasn't his day. Luckily for Lorraine, it wasn't anything a vodka rocks and a piece of toast couldn't fix. Ryan's aggression often bled into his poetry. After an online relationship with a supermodel turned out to be his high school janitor, James dreaded dating. Unable to think of a clever voicemail greeting, Tim got Ron Howard to do it. Please leave a message. What started out as a dry run ended up messy for Zach. Twitter was never the same after it changed its policy regarding mouse accounts. Hey, Ted, look! I'm narrating Katie's tweet. Out of all the things Camille could have had an Oscar-winning director narrate, she chose lunch. Your narrator's latest movie, Rush, opening September 20th, was on its way to becoming a trending topic. Jim was a man on a mission, or according to his disappointed parents, on a mission to become a man. Abby wasn't great at a lot of things, but one thing she was really great at was being terrible at things. Though Stephanie blamed her bad driving habits on a holiday in England, the CHP didn't buy it. After a run of horrible dates, Josh decided to nurture his relationship with something already attached to him. And that's when Lucy realized that no amount of to-do lists would help her fix this mess. And for the first time, Ron Howard read to the world what Rick writes. Hey, that's his last name. After finishing season 4 for the second time, Luke continued his post-2006 sad walk. Please give this man season 5. This is the story of a Spanish student who finished university and tried to find a job. This is graduate development. In an attempt to make a better Valentine's, Mateus asked Ron Howard to say, "Happy Valentine's, Carolina." Adam's dinner was ruined by a loose seal on the vinegar jar. Lucille's dinner was just ruined by Adam. Ellen felt conflicted. Was she a never nude or just a big fan of cutoffs?